get the 2023 Clownfish comic books, including Crimson Wren Volume 1 and previously on Clownfish TV. We're offering a limited number of these books in our second chance offer. Go to shopclownfish.com. That's shopclownfish.com. Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Neon, and we're going to talk about Stephen Amell from the Arrowverse. He is in trouble again. Man, this guy keeps getting in trouble just for speaking his mind. I wouldn't know anything about that. But we're going to talk about Stephen Amell in trouble for making comments about the SAG-AFTRA strike, the WGA strike, of course, as a hot topic right now in Hollywood. And he's kind of gotten into some hot water, and then he had to walk those comments back, but not before getting slammed by his co-stars in the Arrowverse. So we're going to talk about this. Before we get into it any further, please subscribe for more pop culture, news, views, and rants, guys. Geeky's not in this video, so you're not getting a woohoo. Actually, you know what would incentivize me to give you a woohoo is if you go out to shopclownfish.com and check out our wares. Check out our pre-order campaign for Crimson Wren. Crimson Wren is actually in stock. If you guys haven't seen this book, I gotta show you this book. This book is beautiful. Look at this. The books are in stock. A couple months late because of the printer, but it's hardcover. Beautifully, beautifully illustrated by Jose Garcia. This is actually a prequel to the Shadowbinders webcomic, and it looks as good as an animated movie. It's really, really high quality stuff, guys. We're very proud of this book. You can check that out. You can get your copy at shopclownfish.com if you missed the Indiegogo and the Kickstarter campaign for it. Look at that. Amazing work. And Volume 2 is going to be coming next year. We're going to probably crowdfund that at the end of this year after Shadowbinders 3. So help support the channel. And you can also grab Previously on Clownfish TV, which is a collection of comic strips about Clownfish TV, if you can believe that, from Jim Wong. He did a whole bunch of strips. Originally, we were going to do this as a webcomic, but they were so funny, we decided to put them into a book. So that's enough shilling for me right now. Let's talk about Stephen Amell. He has to clarify his anti-strike comments. Well, what anti-strike comments are we talking about? Go out to TMZ, because, you know, everybody in Hollywood loves TMZ. Arrow star Stephen Amell doesn't support the SAG-AFTRA strike. How very dare he? To be honest, I don't really support it that much either. I think that there are some valid points. We've talked about it. We're actually eligible to join SAG-AFTRA. I have no desire to join SAG-AFTRA because I don't like them dictating when I can and can't work. And they've also proven themselves to be hypocrites. Some people are working. Some people in Hollywood are still working. They're working on independent movies. So they're not working on movies for like Warner Brothers or Disney or Universal, but they're working on stuff for like A24. And these are Oscar-winning actors and actresses. It's not like, you know, some no-name or whatever. It's like, you know, there are actually some pretty big names that are still working. So apparently, it's just the plebs that have to go on strike. So let's go to the original version, then we'll go to the update. Stephen Amell is a bit of a walking contradiction. On one hand, he says he backs his union amid the ongoing strike, but on the other, he doesn't approve of them actually striking. The Arrow star made the controversial comments during a recent promotional appearance in North Carolina, where he was plugging a new season of his star show Heels. Never heard of that. Star show Heels. I'll have to look into it. And breaking with the SAG-AFTRA strike protocol in doing so. Actors aren't supposed to be promoting projects during the strike, but there was Stephen plugging away and not holding back on his opinion on the work stoppage, calling it unproductive and unnecessary. Take a listen for yourself. His disdain for how SAG is handling things is clear, although he does say he supports them as an organization. What he doesn't condone is its decision to shut down the industry to get what they want. But they're not shutting the industry down. That's what's so irritating about this. They're telling everybody they need to stop working while a whole bunch of people are still working. Just some of you, the poorest of you, have to stop working, but all these A-listers can keep working, right? Let's listen to what he has to say.
I'm insulated in Hollywood because that's where I live. I literally live in Hollywood.
What?
Like all the stereotypes that exist. So I feel like a lot of people in this room aren't aware of the strike.
How can you not be? How can you not be aware of it?
I do, and I stand with them. I do not support striking. I don't. I think that it is a reductive negotiating tactic. I find the entire thing incredibly frustrating, and I think that the thinking as it pertains to shows like the show that I'm on that premiered last night, I think
apparently people have heard of it. I haven't heard of it.
I stand with my union.
There were a lot of people at San Diego that were promoting, well, they were technically not promoting movies. They were technically not promoting TV shows or whatever, but they were still there. Like Jamie Lee Curtis was there, but she was technically there because I guess her kid is a streamer or something. And other people had comic book projects. And yeah, so they kind of worked around it. I get the feeling that not everybody in Hollywood is really into this strike. They're doing it because they have to do it. But if you don't do it, Fran Drescher is going to show up on your doorstep and give you a talking to. You know, she is. So you got to toe the line. Ask Sarah Silverman how that worked out for her. You have to toe the line. You know, you can't say anything about it. Of course, his remarks are not sitting well with other actors in the biz, and Amell is getting dragged on social media right now as a would-be traitor and a scab. A lot of folks are pointing out his sentiment doesn't actually make sense, arguing it's all or nothing. Well, here's the thing. Here's the pushback. Gizmodo. The first thing they said, we're sorry to say, but the star of the Green Arrow might be a bit of an a-hole. Speaking at GalaxyCon in North Carolina, Stephen Amell had some disappointing thoughts on the current WGA and SAG-AFTRA strikes, which makes him the most vocal star so far to speak out against the work stoppage. Really? However, after he got a healthy dose of backlash from actors and media alike, he made another statement clarifying and contextualizing his thoughts. After Fran Drescher slashed his tires, he changed his tune. I support my union. I do. I stand with them, but I do not support striking. He said in Deadline. And he had to issue another statement, because that's what you do in Hollywood. You say an oopsie. You get a talking to by your agent or your studio or your PR person or somebody, and then you have to walk it back if you don't want to get canceled. You know, he has to stay in line here. Understandably, there's been a lot of reaction to the comments I made this weekend about our strike. To ensure there is no misunderstanding about my thoughts and intentions, I'm providing what I actually said in clarity and context to ensure my feelings aren't unintentionally misinterpreted. We all know sound bites can be taken out of context, and I have too much respect for my fellow union members not to clarify the record. Now, just before we go into that, right, this is not the first time he's gotten backlash. Just a couple of years ago, we made some comments about BLM, and they were pretty mild takes, and he got dragged on social media for that because he wasn't in lockstep with everybody else in Hollywood, and he's kind of like, well, I'm from Canada. A lot of this stuff doesn't make sense to me. So they're watching this guy. They're watching him because God forbid they mistake you for a conservative or something. You know, God forbid they mistake you for a moderate. God forbid they mistake you for an independent thinker or somebody who, puts their own careers, their own interests above people who frankly wouldn't do the same for you. You know, I'm being honest. That's usually how it works, right? So let's go out and see what he said here. What he actually said. I support my union. I do. I stand with them. He said, this doesn't need much clarity. My support is unconditional, and I stand with them. What I actually said, I do not support striking. I don't what this means in full context. I understand fundamentally why we're here. My off-the-cuff use of the word support. Oh, come on. Come on, dude. You shouldn't have to break it down like this for morons. He had to do this before over his BLM statements. My off-the-cuff use of the word support is clearly contradictory to my true feelings and my emphatic statement that I stand with my union. Of course, I don't like striking. Nobody does, but we have to do what we have to do. He said, I think it's a reductive negotiating tactic, and I find the entire thing incredibly frustrating. In full context, I'm an actor, and I was speaking extemporaneously. for over an hour. I emote, but I certainly don't think these issues are simple. Our leadership has an incredibly complicated job, and I'm grateful for all that they do. Despite some of my terrible early acting work, I assure you I'm not a robot. From an intellectual perspective, I understand why we're striking. That doesn't mean it isn't emotionally frustrating on many levels. It is, especially when your beloved union, Stephen, is letting certain people work and other people can't work. That to me, that is irritating. I would be incredibly irritating. It's either all or nothing. And the thing is that the whole situation, again, my point of view as a YouTube commentator, not a professional actor, but my point of view is that is an incredibly frustrating situation because the studios are playing all you. Like they know what they're doing. They're going to use the strikes. They wanted you to strike. They wanted you to strike so they can cancel shows and movies that they greenlit, that they don't have the money for, they don't want now for whatever reason because the flavor of the month has changed. That's what's actually going on. That's what's so irritating about the whole thing. It's like everybody's playing everybody else here, but you can't be an individual. You're not allowed to be an individual. Well, I said, I think that thinking as it pertains to shows like the show I'm on that premiered last night, apparently people heard of it. I haven't heard of it, but cool. I think it's myopic. What I meant, nothing about the strike is funny, but if I may self-deprecate for a moment, I have no clue what I was trying to say here. And who says, I think that thinking, perhaps I was an inarticulate shout out. It was an inarticulate shout out to our crew and cast who mean the world to me. I'm simply sad that we don't have a chance to celebrate a show that all of us figuratively and literally broke my back for. Literally? He broke his back for? Wow, that sucks. Yeah, as I said from the jump, I want to ensure my thoughts and intentions are not misconstrued. The situation reminds me of the proverb, the road to hell is paved with good intentions. Apparently, after reading a limited amount of the commentary, it's a place many of you would like me to visit. However, at least for the foreseeable future, I choose to stand with my union. At least for the foreseeable future. I think there is going to come a time when it's not going to be a given that a lot of these entertainers, writers work with a union or work, you know, under union rules, because it's going to become incredibly limiting. And I think we're going to see that Netflix would rather cut a deal with somebody that's not part of the union, because we'd rather not have everything just grind to a halt. If you're okay with us doing XYZ thing and your coworker isn't okay with doing, or your other union member isn't okay with us doing XYZ thing, why can't we work with you if those terms are acceptable? You know what I'm saying? Like, this is any other job, any other industry. Here's what the job description is. Here's what we pay. Here's what we offer in benefits. Now, you're going to be competitive because you're going to try to get the best people you can get. But any other industry, here's what we pay. Here are the terms of your employment. Can we make a deal, yes or no? But it doesn't seem to work that way in Hollywood. It's like, no, everybody's going to have the same deal. You know, and I get if there's like rampant abuse, I get it. I get the AI thing being concerning, but if you don't do it, somebody else is going to. They'll just generate actors whole cloth. The technology is almost there. I'm just saying, like, if they're gonna do it, if they're hellbound on doing it, you know, they're gonna do it. Simone, the movie Simone. Right? Maybe we'll get Gem out of it. Maybe we'll actually get Gem and the holograms out of it, and we'll have better music than we have now. His fellow Arrowverse co-stars are blasting him. They're blasting him. Among the stronger reactions was Kirk Acevedo, who played Ricardo Diaz, aka the Dragon, a crime kingpin in Arrow season 6 and 7. The actor tweeted, "This fucking guy," along with additional emojis expressing his distaste for Amell's stance. Matt Letcher, who was featured in both Legends of Tomorrow and The Flash as Reverse Flash, yeah, let his opinion be known regarding Amell's comments. Still waiting on that comprehensive list of totally non-reductive negotiating tactics we get to employ now. Thank God for superheroes. Any second now, he tweeted. Two people had a problem with him. No, I'm sure Twitter took him to task. I have no doubt. Look, dude. You obviously are a square peg in the round hole of Hollywood. And Hollywood loves to shove things in holes. Sometimes they don't fit as well as they're supposed to. I'm just saying, like, the dude is constantly getting in trouble and then he's constantly walking it back. And at some point, just be like, I'm going to do what I'm going to do. Fuck all you. You want to work with me? Yes or no? And then he probably can't do that. You know, that's what's so irritating. He probably can't do that. He probably can't say, hey, I'm my own man and I'm going to do what I'm going to do. I'm going to say what I want to say because he won't get to work in that system anymore. You know, but it looks worse, I think, in a lot of ways to constantly find yourself on the receiving end of some kind of, trumped up PR backlash. And then you have to kind of, with your tail between your legs, you have to walk it back. You know, I think the vast majority of people agree with a lot of the things that Stephen Amell says. He seems like he's pretty down to earth, you know, but in Hollywood, you're not allowed to say these things. Very mild takes. Hey, I don't really agree with the strike, but I'm going to support my union. That's a very, very mild take. Hey, I don't fully understand what's going on right now with the BLM thing because I'm from Canada, but you know, I don't see a lot of the racism maybe because I've had a sheltered life, but I'm not seeing it. You can't say that in Hollywood. Maybe it's time for Stephen Amell to move to like Idaho. Move to Idaho and start your own studio. Like the dude has his own promotions company, I think. I think he books a lot of gigs for actors to do conventions. Start your own studio. Start your own production company. Make your own shit and then just, you know, job it out or send it out or get it picked up by like a Netflix or something. Set your own terms, you know, be like, hey, we're a non-union independent studio. You know, we do things the way we want to do it. We work outside the Hollywood system and then we just job it out. We send it someplace, you know, Hollywood can distribute my stuff, but they don't dictate what I make. They don't get to dictate what I say. I think this is going to be the new normal pretty soon. I think an unintentional result of this strike for a lot of people is an eye-opening experience. It's like, wait a second. Why, if I was willing to work, why did I have to go on strike too? Why, if I was okay with certain things, did I have to go on strike too? Why are you letting certain Oscar-winning actors and actresses still work, but you're telling me I can't? I got to be out there on the picket line. But they're allowed to work because it's independent. Well, maybe I want to be independent too. Maybe I want to be independent of you. Maybe I want to control my own future. Maybe I don't want you guys all telling me. We all got to do the same things. The most ridiculous thing, again, from an influencer's perspective, is the amount of sway they think they have over people like me, over YouTubers and TikTokers and Instagrammers and all these people. If you ever want to be part of this union, you can't say anything bad about the union ever. You can't promote any of the studio projects at all, or we'll ban you, blacklist you from the union. You can go fuck yourself. Seriously, I don't care. A lot of people, well, some people care, but a lot of people going forward are not going to care because it's not going to matter as much. I think this strike in particular is going to fracture the entertainment industry like it's never been fractured before. We're going to see projects get canceled. We're going to see studios using non-union labor. We're going to see people starting their own production companies. We're going to see Netflix and Warner and all these other companies getting work from overseas, getting shows content from overseas. You know, all these shows that these people were working on that they want, oh yeah, we need 20 writers in the writer's room. They have to be of certain diverse, whatever background. That's going to end. You're not getting that. You know, and I think that they will still work with unionized talent. I have no doubt they will, but I think it's going to be a lot fewer people. And I think this is going to be a huge paradigm shift, you know, and I think that's what they wanted. I think this is what the studios wanted and y'all played into it. That's just my own personal opinion. Not a big fan of unions. I'd rather cut my own deal. I'd rather be my own man. That's just me. That's just me. Your miles may vary, right? I've had the potential to join unions before and I've always passed. So I'm going to wrap this up. Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. We'll talk later. Help support the channel. Go to thereef.support and get early access to podcasts, videos, and other content. That's thereef.support.